Good day, folks. In this video, we can take a look into the backup and restore process of Hive. Okay, so this is the second part of BDR tutorial. And so here, so if you have already watched the previous video, so you can see how we are taking the backup of HDFS and storing it into a DR cluster and then recovering back. The similar way I'm using a replication for Hive here and trying to restore the database. So I have two cluster, so which is hosted in Amazon AWS. The production one looks like this prod with these are the services running. So I have Hive, Yarn, HDFS and Zookeeper, and another cluster DR, okay, so with the similar services, and Hive is also here. Hive is here also. So the first thing, similar to HDFS backup, the first thing I need to add is, so go to the backup and add pair cluster. So if you already added that, so you can skip this step. So I'm just adding my pair cluster here and add pair. So if you already did, no need to do it again. So I don't have any cluster added at this time. So you have to do this operation at DR side, not in the production cluster. So the cluster name I'm just adding is prod underscore cluster, and this URL, so I can use the public or private URL. So let me get the private URL, like so this is the URL or host name of my prod cluster, then use http://, this one, 7180. So the Cloudera manager URL and Cloudera manager credentials. So add that. Okay. So the status is showing green. So that means I'm okay to go to the next phase. Okay. So if you are showing us a warning or error, so you need to troubleshoot that. Again, if you want to edit, so we have option to edit and test connectivity. So which is already done and it's showing us connected. So before doing this, so similar to the HDFS backup, so we need to make sure, so we are using enterprise distribution. So make sure at least enterprise trial or enterprise distribution. So both DR and prod cluster. So otherwise this option won't be there, backup option. So we'll select that and do a replication schedule. Click this replication schedule. Then there is no schedule running at this time. So if you have Hive schedule, so leave HDFS schedule, leave it as it is, then add a new schedule. So here we have two options, HDFS replication and Hive replication. So HDFS replication, so we have already seen, so that I uploaded in the previous videos. So I'm selecting Hive replication, select that, and the one name, something like that, Hive underscore replication, some name I'm giving, and the source is my production cluster and the destination is my DR cluster. So by default, Hive will take all the databases. Okay, so again we can customize this. So if you have some database or at least some tables, you can do that. So let me check the tables available here. So this is my production cluster. So I'm going to take the backup of only this particular table, not entire table. So if you want to do the backup of entire table, so you can do that. But for this time, I'm selecting the table with training name. So I'm writing that name here. That's it. And what is the schedule? If you want to do it in a recurring fashion or once or immediate. So I'm doing it in an immediate. So that means it at this time. So here also we have options for resources and advanced options, like what are the force override, then replicate, etc, etc. So okay, so save this schedule. Okay, the source cluster supports HDFS, but HDFS snapshots are not enabled. So we need to enable HDFS snapshot for Hive warehouse location in our source cluster. So we will go to the Cloudera recommends that you enable HDFS snapshots for Hive warehouse directory. Okay, so go to the Hive configuration. Then search for configuration and find out the warehouse directory. So go to the warehouse. So this is the location. So this directory, so you need to enable snapshot. So go to HDFS, then go to the file browser option, and then go to this directory. Then enable snapshot. Okay, so this thing I am doing at the production cluster level. So at the production cluster, so I am enabling this snapshot. Okay, so there are no snapshots, so just take a snapshot also. So that this time, okay, so first snapshot. Okay, so it will take some time and take the snapshot in a moment. Okay, so done. So we'll go back to our main cluster, I mean DR cluster. Then yeah, proceed anyway. So we have done that. Okay, we can go with this confirmation. Then internal server error. So what could be the reason? Yeah, save schedule. Just let me add it again. So Hive replication, then Hive underscore repli. Then instead of replicate all, so what are the databases we want, just choose the databases, then table. So I'm just writing as a star for writing all the tables, immediate, and the save the schedule. So regular expression table is disallowed. So line breaks or code. Okay, so let me, okay, so star is not needed, just write that table. So previously that some connection issue something goes that showed that internal server error. So now the replication is happening, so it will take some time to finish this. So we'll have to wait that till this operation finish. So you can see that details like show history if you have previous backup, and everything you can see from here. Show history will show what are the backups you have taken and what are the jobs. This is successful or any error, so something like that. So now we will go back to our DR cluster. Okay, so this is, where is our DR cluster? And now, okay, so I think it's disconnected. So let me connect it again. Login with the root, then connect as Hive, and I need to verify these databases, whatever the databases, show databases. I think it is not still not replicated, so we'll wait some time. Okay, so one mistake I did, like my tables are not replicating, so I have not given anything under table session. So once I give the table name, so then it started creating. So this is my DR cluster, and if it show databases, it is showing that training database, so which is supposed to get here. So use a training, and I can see show tables. So one table, okay, so which I specified here is copied. So initially I did without any table name, so that is why the replication was not working. So now this is working fine, and if I want to add one more table, okay, so let me check the contents inside that. Select star from fruits. Yes, the values are also there. So here so I need to check what are the other values. Show tables, then employee. So I want to copy this one also, just add that. So training, then employee, then save this schedule. Then I'm just doing a dry run. So dry run actually will not run the real job, but just we can make sure so everything works properly. So it will try to simulate the whatever the steps it's do in actual phase. So we can see that status here. So if it works fine, then we can directly go ahead and submit the replication. I mean, we can start the replication soon. Okay, so dry run. I hope the dry run is okay. So that now we can directly go ahead and run this job. Okay, so it's just started. And in backend, if you go to this training and type the check the tables, so it will take some time and it will take the backup of the other that table also in a moment. So we have to wait till this. Also, you can schedule this on a recurring basis to do the backup on a daily basis or weekly based on that. Okay, so we can do the backup of entire Hive database. Okay, also or a specific particular database. So we'll take some time. So we'll wait until it reach 100%. So now this replication is completed. So now if I check the tables, so I can see the new table also reached to this DR cluster. So this is how we can add a replication to a DR location. So go to the DR, so make sure so you enable a snapshot on the data warehouse location in the Hive in the production, and on in the destination you just need to add the pair first. So if already added the pair, so make sure it's able to connect, then go to the replication schedule and create a new Hive replication here, then use the some name and use the source and destination, and by default it replicates all the database. So choose the database and the table, but I think it support regular expression also, but star dot star it's not taking. So let's try something else later. So but I hope, I think this is a mandatory field, not optional. So I not added anything, so this database also not created. Then the schedule you can do in a recurring fashion or a once. So recurring fashion means every, so when you want to do, it's a weekly basis or monthly basis or yearly basis, you can do that. So if you want, or at least immediately once, that's it. And you can use the username, to which username this job has to run. Actually it execute a MapReduce job, which is a distributive operation in backend to copy the data. So again, the scheduler pool and other details we can do. Then advanced, like a force override. So because again, sometimes if you are just trying to restore, so you can use this option. So that's it about the backup process. Okay, so once this is done, make sure, okay, so in a production, so this backup and restore is working properly. So now we will check how we can restore this. Okay, suppose if in my primary or production cluster, so I'm going to drop that database. Okay, so first let me disable and stop this schedule. So disable. Okay, so it's not running, so I'm not deleting at this time. So just go to the master. Okay, I think the terminal got disconnected, and let me restart the session. Okay, so show databases. I'm just dropping this table. Okay, so sorry, dropping this database. Drop database training. Wait. Okay, it's not empty. Okay, fine. The database is not empty, so we have to check. Okay, you can use this cascade option. Then show databases and to make sure so we have properly cleaned. So since the database was not empty, so we had some tables inside that this database training, so we were not able to drop this by using drop database. So we can use this cascade flag along with that, so that it delete. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is just go to the primary location or production location, so where I want to restore. So go to the backup, then check the peer is added or not. If it is not added, so use that dr location host name. Okay, so you can get that dr location host name from here also. Okay, so go to the, because it's a single node instance installation, so this is the host name. Okay, so I'm using the private name since in AWS, because the public DNS, the next time it may change. Okay, so use that, and whatever the credential, admin, then add. Okay, so it's connected. Now go to the same thing, replication schedule, then create a schedule, Hive replication, then name is dr underscore recovery, something like that. So our dr cluster, then this one, then what is the database and table we are using, training, then fruits, then training. Okay, so save this schedule. Okay, so let me go and enable snapshot on the Hive warehouse. Okay, so go to the HDFS, then file browser, go to the Hive warehouse location, so that is under slash user Hive warehouse. So I need to enable snapshot on this directory. Okay, so now I am inside the DR cluster, so I'm just trying to enable the snapshot, and let me take a snapshot also. First snapshot, that's it. So I'm taking the snapshot of that warehouse location. Okay, so that's it, snapshot also has done. So now we again go back, Hive replication, then dr underscore recovery, some name, so which will display here, then replicate, training, so this is the database, and table name is fruits, and if I want to recover the next table also, so training, then employee. So here it's saying, okay, we can use the regular expression instead of direct name, but so when I tried star and star dot star, it was not working. So need to check that, then immediate and save it. So it will do as an immediate effect. So it's trying to restore those databases and tables back to our table. I mean, our Hive, production Hive. So we'll take some time. Again, it also use the backend DCP operation, and it run as a MapReduce or YARN application in backend. So this is completed. So now in we can go back to our production. So only the default database are there. So just check show databases command and see whether the database, yes. So we have got this database back, and go inside and show tables. I think only fruits is copied back. What happened to the employee table? Okay. Because in this also showing us one table copied, so we'll go and edit that, and I think, I don't know whether if I made any typo over here, and so use training, then show tables. Okay, so this is the name employee. Okay, so just typo in my table creation, so that is why it is copied only one table. So just save that, then it's again I can do a dry run for testing or actual run for real run. So I'm not doing the dry run, so I think I'm sure this will work without any issue. So you can get the status here. So how many tables are copied and how many databases are, and what is the objects is copied, custom databases. And now it's in a running state, and in backend it will be running as a MapReduce job, and that tables also will be here in my production cluster. So this is how I can restore my data back in case of any data loss or any error. Okay, so this is how we can do Hive backup and restore process. Okay, so only thing you need is you need to have an enterprise trial, at least enterprise trial or enterprise distribution, and you need an admin or BDR admin access user, and two clusters, so one production and one DR. So you can use a single node instance. I use a single node cluster, DR and prod for testing purpose, and everything I install in a single machine only. So this is only for testing, so I'm not worried about the performance part. So that's why it's taking much time, still it take time, so I can test these features by using a single instance installation. So I hope you like the content. So please subscribe to my channel, and also write your comments below the video. Thank you, bye.